Okay, so let us start the today topic, hysteresis curve or hysteresis loop, that is also sometimes called magnetization curve, and many people say it BH curve. Okay, before entering into the analysis, deep analysis of this topic, first we will understand this content. What is this content? Before going into this content, as we know that if a current is flowing through a wire, conducting wire, a current is flowing through a conducting wire, there will be a magnetic field circulated around the wire. This is known fact. That here, suppose one wire is here and direction of current is here, okay. So there will be a magnetic field circulating around this wire. Direction of magnetic field can be known from the curl method. Either it will be in downward direction or in upward direction. Downward direction is represented by cross marks and upward direction is represented by dot marks. Okay. Now, what is this figure? This figure, here figure drawn in blue line is the solenoid. I have written here it is solenoid. And this is the coil above the solenoid. This blue line, this blue wire is the coil on the solenoid. And this black line represented, black cylinder, is the ferromagnetic material inside the solenoid. Why I have done this, I will explain step by step. This is the ferromagnetic material inside of the solenoid. Here I have applied, here we are having one battery, and this battery voltage is variable in nature. One ammeter is connected from this solenoid. This ammeter is connected to measure the strength of current flowing through this coil. One magnetometer is applied at both terminal of the solenoid to measure the intensity, to measure the strength of the magnetic field. Okay, the way ammeter and voltmeter measure the strength of voltage and current in the circuit, similarly, same way this magnetometer measures the strength of magnetic field in a circuit. Now suppose you feel that this ferromagnetic material is not inside this solenoid, means only empty solenoid is there, one coil is wrapped here and this coil is applied a voltage. Now gradually we have increased the voltage and set at particular value. Suppose it was at zero value and set it at 5 volt or 50 volt or 100 volt at particular volt. Corresponding to that volt, one current will flow in this coil. And as I have already said, if there is a wire or there is a coil and there is current passing through that conducting wire or coil, there will be magnetic field around, circulating around the wire, and direction of magnetic field can be measured using Fleming right hand rule, left hand rule or curl rule. Okay, similarly here through battery a voltage is set up and current is flowing through this coil. Therefore a magnetic field will produce and direction of magnetic field will be from this side left to right. I have represented this magnetic field as B here. Okay, and current flowing through the coil, if there is current flowing through the coil, magnetic field intensity is also directly proportional to the current. H is directly proportional to the current. Okay, this magnetizing current. This H is proportional to the magnetizing current. Now, this ferromagnetic material is kept inside the coil. Inside this solenoid. This ferromagnetic material is kept inside the solenoid. Now, what we will do? We will see if we increase or decrease the magnitude of this voltage, correspondingly magnitude of current will also change, correspondingly field intensity will also change, and a strength of magnetic field will also change. Therefore, what we will see, if a ferromagnetic material is kept, this is the ferromagnetic material, if this ferromagnetic material is kept in the magnetic field produced by us, what will be the behavior of this ferromagnetic what will be the behavior of this ferromagnetic material in the presence of external magnetic field. And if we change the magnitude of this external magnetic field, how it will behave. A step-by-step analysis we will do. Okay, suppose initially this is the ferromagnetic material, and initially this is the ferromagnetic material, and all these lines are the dipole, atomic dipole. And from this ferromagnetic material, we can see that all these atomic dipoles are randomly oriented, not oriented in a particular direction. That is why I am saying it unaligned atomic dipole in absence of external magnetic field. In absence of external magnetic field means, suppose this is the ferromagnetic material and this is kept here, and there is no magnetic field around it. Therefore, atomic dipole inside this ferromagnetic material remains in this fashion. And when this ferromagnetic material is kept in the absence of magnetic field, there will be no net field in the ferromagnetic material. Now, what happens when I keep this ferromagnetic material in the presence of external magnetic field? Suppose now I have kept this ferromagnetic material here in the presence of external magnetic field. Direction of external magnetic field is from left to right. Suppose direction of magnetic field is from left to right. Therefore, the dipole, atomic dipole inside of the ferromagnetic material will align in the direction of external field applied. Okay, this is the ferromagnetic material. When you keep a ferromagnetic material, I have already discussed these things: paramagnetic material, ferromagnetic material, diamagnetic material. When you keep a ferromagnetic material in an external magnetic field, atomic dipole of the ferromagnetic material get aligned in the direction of applied external magnetic field. Okay, so same thing happening here. Here ferromagnetic material was kept in absence of external magnetic field and dipole was randomly oriented. Now here ferromagnetic material is kept in the presence of external magnetic field, and therefore this atomic dipole will orient in the direction of applied external magnetic field. This is the direction of external magnetic field I have taken. Now this external magnetic field aligned. Further, suppose to align this atomic dipole, we required some magnitude of external magnetic field, and all the atoms got aligned in particular direction. If you further increase the strength of external magnetic field, then there is no atomic dipole left to align it further in particular direction. Means, if suppose in initially 5 magnitude I applied, and this magnitude was sufficient to make all these atomic dipole to align in direction. मतलब कि हमें जितना चाहिए था strength, हमें चाहिए था suppose 10 newton है, 10 newton का force लगाया, 10 newton का force लगाने के बाद इसका direction इधर हो गया. अब जो है 11 newton का force लगा देंगे तो भी ये इसी direction में रहेगा, 12 newton का भी लगा देंगे इस direction में तो इसी direction में रहेगा. मतलब कि अब newton force हम कितना भी लगा दें, इसका direction इसी में रहेगा अगर हमको इस direction में align करना था तो. If we had to align in this direction, if you applied sufficient force and it got aligned, then if you further increase the applied force, it will be in the same direction always. Means a limit has reached. Even if you apply further extra magnetic field, there is no atomic dipole left to align in that direction. Means that situation is called desaturation. Means there is no atomic dipole left to align further in a particular direction, and that situation is called saturation. Saturation has come, it got saturated, there is no atomic dipole left further to align from south to left. Now what happens when these atomic dipole get aligned in particular direction and it get fixed in particular direction? What happens when we apply external magnetic field opposite to this direction? After getting this situation, when our atomic ferromagnetic material get aligned in this direction, after that we apply a reverse magnetic field in opposite direction, what happens next? We can see here we can see here ki all the atomic dipole get reversed in this direction, but few left few did not align in opposite direction. Here blue line, all blue arrow represents the in the opposite direction, but two marks is in black, this and this one. These two atomic dipole remains in that direction, in the direction it was earlier. Okay. Therefore, this is the tendency of the ferromagnetic material, that when it attains a particular direction and suddenly you reverse the direction of external magnetic field applied, few atoms remains in the previous direction. Okay. Now come to the hysteresis curve or magnetization curve or BH curve. Suppose initially there was H in this circuit is zero, because voltage was zero, there was not current flowing, and H was zero, and therefore because of this current produced magnetic field in this solenoid was zero. Okay. Now as soon as we increase the voltage, magnitude of current increases, and because of the increase in this magnitude of current, magnetic field suddenly will not produce. This is the magnetic field, this is the magnetic field intensity, which is proportional to I. As soon as we will increase the current, magnetic field will not produce. Why? To generate the magnetic field in this ferromagnetic material, this atomic dipole will take some energy to orient in particular direction. Means because of its inertia, of this dipole, it will remain in those state when it was earlier. And as soon as sufficient magnetic field intensity will applied or sufficient current is given, then all this dipole will oriented and there will be a magnetic field generated in particular direction. Suppose I am pushing it with this force, it is not moving. As soon as we will give sufficient force, it will move. In the same way, if I am giving few current, then this much current or this much magnetic field intensity is not sufficient to generate this magnetic field. When sufficient current is applied, magnetic field will produce. And magnetic field will produce means all these dipole will start aligning in particular direction. When we will keep increasing this H, this magnetic field will also increase. And it will keep increasing, magnetic field will also increase. Why? Because all atomic dipole will keep aligning in particular direction and magnetic field will start generating. Means all this will start orienting in this direction. Okay. A situation will come when you give sufficient current and you reach at a particular point when you have given current, all the atomic dipole get aligned in particular direction. Now if you further increase this value of H, there is no dipole left to orient in this direction. Means a situation has come when you increase the H, B will remain constant, and this situation is called saturation. Now further, what happens when we are increasing H, B is increasing. Will that thing happen? If we reduce the H, will B reduce? If we reduce the H, whether magnetic field will reduce or not, we will check that. As soon as we start reducing H, we can see here B started reducing. When we have reduced the H up to the value of zero, we can see that this B does not come to zero. This B comes here. Means at this point H is zero. Means I is zero. I is applied is zero. Means H is zero. But B is not equal to zero. Why? Because suddenly if we will reverse the direction, few atomic dipole will left. Few atomic dipole will left in the previous direction, and most of the most suppose I have oriented all the 100 dipole in this direction. Here all the 100 dipole oriented in this direction. When magnetic field was applied from south to left to right, when we have applied the magnetic field from right to left, not all the atomic dipole will orient in this direction, only 90, means 10 left in this direction. And that 10 represents, because of that 10, magnetic field remained existed, means even if we make this H0, magnetic field remained in this direction in this ferromagnetic material. And this is the call, this is the called retention, retentivity, capacity to retain. कहने का मतलब ये है कि अगर हमने सारा एटॉमिक डाइपोल को इस डायरेक्शन में लेफ्ट टू राइट ओरिएंट कर दिया था, सपोज हमारे 100 एटॉमिक डाइपोल थे, सारे 100 एटॉमिक डाइपोल को हमने इस डायरेक्शन में ओरिएंट कर दिया, जब अपोजिट डायरेक्शन में मैग्नेटिक फील्ड अप्लाई करते हैं, अपोजिट डायरेक्शन में मैग्नेटिक फील्ड अप्लाई करते हैं, तो क्या होता है कि सारे के सारे 100 जो एटॉमिक डाइपोल थे अपोजिट डायरेक्शन में फिर से अलाइन नहीं होते हैं, 100 में से 10 बच जाते हैं, और वो जो 10 बचे हैं, जब 100 इस डायरेक्शन में हो गया था तो इस डायरेक्शन में मैग्नेटिक फील्ड जनरेट हो गया, जब 100 में से 90 इधर हो गए, 10 इधर बच गए, तो वो 10 जो है इस डायरेक्शन में कुछ ना कुछ मैग्नेटिक फील्ड कैरी करते हैं, यानी कि मैग्नेटिक फील्ड को, इस डायरेक्शन के मैग्नेटिक फील्ड को कुछ ना कुछ बचा कर रखते हैं, जो कि हमने ब्लैक से रिप्रेजेंट किया है। तो वही जब हमने एच को जीरो कर दिया, एच को जैसे एच को घटाया, एच को घटा करके हमने क्या किया कि जीरो कर दिया, एच को घटाया, घटाते घटाते जीरो कर दिया, तो हमारा जो है फिर भी मैग्नेटिक फील्ड जो है, हमारा मैग्नेटिक इंटेंसिटी जो है वो जीरो होने के बाद भी हमारा मैग्नेटिक फील्ड जीरो नहीं हुआ। तो मैग्नेटिक फील्ड को जीरो करने के लिए हम और थोड़ा एक्स्ट्रा फोर्स देंगे, मीन्स कि अगर हमने यहाँ 100 मैग्नीट्यूड फोर्स लगाया था तो 100 के 100 डाइपोल इधर हो गए, अब इधर हमने क्या किया 100 फोर्स अपोजिट में लगाए, तो हमारा 100 अपोजिट में नहीं गया, ये 90 ही हमारा अपोजिट डायरेक्शन में गया, 10 बच गए। इस 10 को और रिवर्स करने के लिए हम 10 और लगाएंगे, मींस 110 हमको लगाना पड़ा, हमें 110 लगाना पड़ा इसको 100 करने के लिए, 100 करने के लिए 110 लगाना पड़ा, तब जाके ये मींस यहां पर हमारा मैग्नीट्यूड जो है मैग्नेटिक फील्ड का कुछ बच गया। वी हैव टू मेक दिस मैग्नेटिक फील्ड जीरो, टू मेक दिस मैग्नेटिक फील्ड जीरो अगेन वी विल अप्लाई दिस फील्ड, वी विल रिवर्स द डायरेक्शन ऑफ दिस फील्ड, दिस इंटेंसिटी, दिस करेंट, एंड ए सिचुएशन विल कम व्हेन दिस फील्ड विल बी जीरो, दिस फील्ड बी जीरो मींस दिस इज द एक्स्ट्रा फोर्स वी अप्लाइड टू ओरिएंट द ऑल द डायपोल इन अपोजिट डायरेक्शन। हाउ वी विल अचीव दिस नेगेटिव फील्ड हेयर, यहाँ पे हमने मैग्नेटिक, यहाँ पे हमने वोल्ट लगाया, वोल्टेज सोर्स लगाया इस डायरेक्शन में, जब हम क्या करेंगे इस डायरेक्शन में मैग्नेटिक फील्ड जनरेट हुआ था, अब जो हमने क्या किया इसको रिड्यूस किया, रिड्यूस किया तो आई का वैल्यू रिड्यूस हुआ, जिसकी से बी का वैल्यू रिड्यूस हुआ, वैल्यू ऑफ बी हैज गॉट रिड्यूस्ड व्हेन वी रिड्यूस द वोल्टेज ऑफ वोल्टेज वी, एंड कॉरस्पॉन्डिंगली एच रिड्यूस्ड एंड आई रिड्यूस्ड, एंड ए सिचुएशन कम व्हेन वी बिकम जीरो, आई बिकम जीरो, एच बिकम जीरो, बट देयर इज स्टिल फ्यू बी लेफ्ट इन दिस डायरेक्शन, देयरफॉर टू रिवर्स दैट लेफ्ट फील्ड इन अपोजिट डायरेक्शन वी रिवर्स द डायरेक्शन ऑफ फ्लो ऑफ करेंट बाय अपोजिंग द पोलैरिटी ऑफ वोल्टेज सोर्स, बाय रिवर्सिंग द पोलैरिटी ऑफ वोल्टेज सोर्स, एंड देन अगेन फ्यू करेंट अप्लाइड इन नेगेटिव डायरेक्शन सो दैट वी कैन मेक दिस बी जीरो, हेयर वी हैव मेड बी इक्वल टू जीरो, हेयर बी इज जीरो, बट वी हैव इंक्रीज द वैल्यू ऑफ बी इन अपोजिट डायरेक्शन इन नेगेटिव डायरेक्शन, एंड हेयर आई इज नॉट जीरो एंड एच इज नॉट जीरो बट बी इज जीरो, दिस इज कॉल्ड, दिस पॉइंट इज कॉल्ड कोरेसिव फोर्स, एक्स्ट्रा फोर्स इज अप्लाइड टू मेक इट जीरो एंड दिस इज कॉल्ड कोरेसिव फोर्स, एंड हेयर कम टू दिस पॉइंट हेयर व्हेन दिस बिकम जीरो एंड नाउ यू इंक्रीज द करेंट इन अपोजिट डायरेक्शन, देन एच विल इंक्रीज एंड बी विल इंक्रीज इन अपोजिट डायरेक्शन, अगेन सेचुरेशन विल कम एंड अगेन यू रिवर्स द पोलैरिटी अगेन इट टू पॉजिटिव, दिस विल बिकम पॉजिटिव एंड देन इट विल स्टार्ट गोइंग इन, नो यू जस्ट रिड्यूस, स्टार्ट रिड्यूसिंग इन अपोजिट डायरेक्शन एंड मेक दिस एच जीरो एंड देन रिवर्स द पोलैरिटी अगेन, देन इन द लास्ट व्हेन यू विल रिवर्स द पोलैरिटी अगेन देन इट विल अगेन विल बिकम जीरो एंड इट विल फॉलो दिस पाथ, इट विल फॉलो दिस पाथ, मीन्स it will start from here, it will increase up to this value, and when you will reduce the value of H, this will start reducing, H will become 0, but B will not become 0 here. When you will reverse the H, this B will 0. When you will further reverse the H in opposite direction, magnetic will field generate and it will saturate. And when you will start reducing the field in negative direction, this field will come to this point. Now you reverse the field again here, this will become, magnetic will become 0, and this loop will keep forming. And therefore this is for the only initial stage. Later on this will not be here, and this will loop keep forming. This was the initial stage. So what is the magnetization? This is called magnetization curve. What is the magnetization curve? This portion is magnetization. Why? This was the duration when our ferromagnetic material was getting magnetized, and when we were reducing the value of H, our ferromagnetic material was getting demagnetized, but it was having magnetic capability only because of this retentive force. Therefore here what we call OB is the residual magnetism. This much magnetism left in the ferromagnetic material, and this OC is called the coercivity, and this is also called coercive force. This is the magnetization part, and this is the demagnetization part. The process of magnetization and demagnetization of a magnetic material on the variation of magnetic field intensity means when we are applying in positive direction, it is magnetizing. When we are reversing the magnetic field, it is demagnetizing. And the process of magnetizing and demagnetizing on the variation of this voltage, current, and this magnetic field intensity, and the formation of, because of variation in this value, and the formation of curve is called the hysteresis curve.